Hello, my name is Veerle Haverals and I work for the University of Antwerp, Belgium. This ILSA project video will give an overview on how to use speech tools for punctuation while we're speaking from language A into language B. We continue to build on what you have learned in the previous modules, that is, the modules on subtitling, on simultaneous interpreting, and on intralingual respeaking. With speech commands, you can dictate full stop, comma, exclamation marks, and question marks. But you can also open the brackets and close the brackets again. In this unit, you will have to dictate with those speech commands in your own language while respeaking a text, for example, from English into Spanish. This is especially difficult if you're used to intralingual subtitling in language A, and then you have to interpret into language B, which is maybe not your mother tongue. Let's have a look. For example, in Dragon, you can also have the automatic punctuation. Dragon can automatically add periods and commas at the appropriate places in your dictation, without you having to explicitly speak that punctuation. That natural punctuation feature can be useful in helping you to get used to dictation by focusing on what you are saying rather than how your speech is punctuated. So these are small things that can actually help you, but you don't have to use it. It's an option. Here we have an overview of the different punctuations and how you have to pronounce them in order to get them correctly on the screen. Let us have a look. These are overviews of commands that Dragon is using. For example, to erase the last thing you said, you can say scratch that. You can continue to repeat scratch that to undo a sequence of phrases. Or you can say undo that to undo the action. You can also put items in bold by saying bold that, putting it in capitals by saying cap that, or making corrections by saying correct that. Here we have a general overview of all the different commands. Let's have a closer look. So here you will have an overview of the different question mark, comma, semicolon, dash, and dash, apostrophe. And as you saw in the presentation, you can find this on nuance.com on the pages about Dragon. We will start with easier videos and gradually move on to more advanced and difficult material. The purpose of this training is to concentrate on specific challenges of working with speech recognition, more specifically incorporating punctuation. So, now you work, read the text in language A, re-speak it in language B, and dictate all the speech commands, and try to use your keyboard the least possible.